Good morning. Today we're going to be assembling the Mecpow X3 Pro 10 watt laser engraver. Seems to be a pretty decent kit so far. It comes with your laser module, which is pre-plumbed for air assist. It comes with an air assist pump, the tube, the necessary cables, got your legs, your gantry, your power or control box, your X-axis bars or rails, and your Y-axis rails. Let's assemble this thing together. Now your left Y-axis has a limit switch on it. So does the gantry. So it will always home to the same area. It comes with a package of screws, various screws. The longer screws go and hold your access bars together. You just use the included little screwdriver to assemble it. I believe the length on these screws are the 30 millimeter screws. All of the bars are very well machined. Everything seems to be of good quality. All right, so we've got the left and right and attached to the front. Next thing that goes on is the gantry, which like this, if we can get it to go in there. There we go. That goes in there. Four. Oh, I got it turned around backwards. Thought that looked funny. There we go. This looks better. Forward, and we put our control box up here. Now the limit switch down here in the front corner has got to plug into the control box, so we can't forget to do that when we get everything attached together. There we go. That is on. We will turn it around and put the rear axis in. X-axis. Well, that's two 30 millimeter screws. Tighten this other side up. Now the hardest part about this whole assembly is going to be putting the belts on, because it has to go in or under, up, over, down, and under again, and it's kind of hard to do. All right, now there's three three legs. There's two right and one left. It's because your other left is your control box up front. Then there's little short screws with washers. They go to the outside, because those little washers is what locks the belt in place. When you put the little short screws in, just put them in a couple of turns. Don't snug them down, because you'll have to loosen them back up then. Now this unit comes with flame detection, comes with limit switches to help at home. Comes with a key to lock it so nobody comes in and just turns the thing on in one spot. Comes with a emergency off, also comes with a, if it tilts for some odd reason, it'll shut off automatically. Pretty much the same features that supposable high dollar units. This one comes with an air assist pump, which the others don't. Now they are in the process of getting Y-axis extension. We'll make it 29 inches long by 15 inches wide. And they have a rotary module that is on the way. All right. Now we have the basic system. Now we're going to work with the belts. This one over here for the time being. There is a slot in the top of the leg that it goes through. I said just pull your belt through. I try to leave like an equal amount on each end and pull it tight. Tighten this one down. And there we have the one side. Now let's do that again on the other side. Same step, slide something down inside the channel. So the belt rides up. and then pull the belt up through. Come in from the back side to keep the belt from going backwards. And there we have that one. Same thing, through the little screw on the front. It wants to snag on the washer a little bit. That's the case, loosen your washer up or your screw up a little bit more. Tighten this one down. Pull your belt through. Tighten the front one back down. And there we have it. Quick and easy assembly. Now the laser module assembly has got one power connector on the top. It plugs in. It is keyed so it only plugs in one way. It's got a little set screw on the side to lock it in. You just slide it down on the bracket and then lock the screw down. And that is in place. And when you go to focus it, it comes with a little shield. You set down, set your laser head down on top of it, pull your little plate out, and your shield or your laser is now focused at the proper distance. And we also have to come back over here. Plug these two in for the limit switch. Again, it's keyed, it'll only go one direction. Let's see here, we want to put in the laser or the air assist. Now this is set so one end is threaded. It will thread into the laser assembly. Probably should do that with it off. There we go. Put that back down onto there. And we've got this tube. The tube will take a while for it to come up with its own curve, undo its curves. But this is just a push fit onto there. Ooh, it is a very tight fit, which is a good thing. All right. I think that will the laser back in. Take a cut one of the little zip ties it comes with. Zip tie these together. We have the power module, which goes here. I have an extension cord down here on the floor. We will plug power. Now let's plug in the air assist pump, make sure it works like it's supposed to work. Air assist does work. Now, let me get my laptop, we'll plug it in and hook it up to Lightburn.